either put a lot of that in, you can make your whole bundle out of Mugwort, or just add it to your tilt file.
Just taking the time to make the nest first is really important. Don't get your coal and then run around, scramble around, try to put something together. He's assuming he will be successful. That's what you want to do.
And you want to make it deep, because if I had it like this and I lay my ember on top, like the top part, you have embers flying all over. You got to remember fire safety. We don't want any fires. Really be careful with this. Okay, so now I think we're ready to go. Remember the two index fingers? That one goes there, this one's here. That thing right around. It's got to be tight. Because if it's not tight,
have you done this, Billy?
My problem is I can't kneel down.
I watched a guy once, he sat in a chair, he had a long drill because he couldn't kneel, and he got a fire sitting down.
Yeah. I could do it like, you know, up here.
Yeah.
You know, or...
He sat in a chair, and he had a drill that was about 3 feet or even long. I was laughing, I couldn't believe it. He was a big guy, you know, and he did it, and bigger than you. I mean, he was a big guy, and he got it in no time, 30 seconds.
It just takes more energy.
Because
you do what you gotta do.
He's using his arms. He's not using his whole body, but he did it.
Yeah, this way, once you get the technique here, you're using practically zero energy. That's the great thing about the bow, is compared to the handle. So, look, pull it all the way back. Remember to keep it parallel to the ground and keep your bow loaded. I can keep my eye on this, so I know I'm keeping it right about there. And with my hand, I can feel my fingers just barely dragging the ground, so I know that I'm not going too high. Okay? You see the 90 degree angle with the drill? 90 degrees to the ground. None of this angle stuff. Okay? Use the whole string, almost. Okay? Just don't get caught up.
Jim's comments should be construed as the scientific aspect of making fire. Because there is a science to doing it quickly and well.
See, I had to angle this one.
Because it was too close. The hole was too close to the edge.
Oh, it was too close.
Look at that. That was quick. That was like 10 seconds, right?
So I never blow on it.
The elephant's not here.
Yeah.
And now I don't just pop my foot off, because the whole thing might go flying. Sometimes your foot sticks to the board. So hold it secure with your finger and then... And then you want to nudge, don't poke it, but nudge it out, because you want to break that ember apart, okay? And add all of this dust. Actually, I'll put this extra dust in.
I got the
ball.
Oh,
okay, thanks. I think we might just
when you play that, you can
put it on. Yeah, I know. So you bring your tinder bundle to your ember. You don't go walking around with this extra. So remember, you want it to be in there deep.
I guess remember, Jim was a professional.
You wait a couple of seconds, I mean like maybe 15 seconds, to let this thing firm up. It will congeal. If you try to move it too fast, then it can fall apart and you lose your heat. So see, I'm just going to take my finger and kind of move it along and lay it in there, and then drop it.
If I can add to that, Jim, I've seen guys blow on this really quick. That's what he means by congeal. They'll blow on it for some odd reason, and it just scatters. You know, just relax, you know,
it's not going to burn out.
It's going to last for a few minutes.
Here we go. I don't think we're going to have the whole fire, Rick. We're just going to...
Is that the fire?
No, I don't think so. Just this.
Yeah. Ready
for it. Yes, okay. I think we'll just do this part.
Okay.
Maybe when we come back, Rick,
so then you just lay on your stuff. You want to
address your stuff?
Yeah,
we can. Well, we can, because see the mugwort is there, and that holds it. So if it goes out, all you have to do is blow it up.
You can see how fire spread in these conditions. It's dry and it's windy, so we do want to be careful. And that little thing that he dropped, that could be that gets out of control.
Down there,
next to your feet.
Oh, yeah, there it is.
Did you like it?
Really? I was surprised.
They're on. See, that's the incredible.
Yeah.
That's the incredible thing about the bugger.
Well, it's good, and that really helps.
That's kind of like a punk
where you can just yeah. Oh, okay.
That's not mugwort, is it?
So inside of it.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Oh, good.
That's awesome.
Good. I'm happy.
Anybody have questions of this? Because you're all going to do it now. You're going to do this, hand drill, magnesium, flint and steel, batteries.
I'm if it's more of a because I mean, yeah. Can you
pick it up? I actually backhand, forgot about it.
Are you keeping tension on any
rocket? Yeah, it was all crunched up.
Sticks on here. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's the great thing about the
muggle. Yeah. I think I might use that for
I was going to say, on your backhand.
My roommate has this little kettle that's got
string.
Yeah,
sometimes if the string's getting a little loose, you can just tighten it up a little bit.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because if you're in the motion, you don't want to stop and then do it, but you put your thumb in there and pull it, get a little bit more tension, tighten it up.
Because I was so close, I wasn't set back enough. Ideally, this board would be a little bit wider.
Yeah.
I had to compensate because it was getting ready to pop out, so I had to really angle that thing. I shouldn't have to do that.
Do you find that too?
Usually, it just went straight up and down.
So like
I was afraid it was going to bust this out.
Instead of getting all the powder
tumbled
up stuff that's in the bag sitting there necessarily.
Yeah.
And one thing that you know is not.
Oh, the other thing, you guys, especially if you're using mugwort,
it's really good.
It's so hard to put out. You've got to make sure it's out.
Or in Chinatown or another
right, mugwort just smolders and smolders.
You know,
yeah,
so like
little breeze coming along, you've got to find it. Mugwort will last for that. This little piece would last at least 15 minutes.
Right.
And you think you got it out, a breeze comes along, and
yeah.
You got your fire you somewhere dirt. You don't want it. So I make sure all the heat's gone before I put this away.
I should, yeah.
Okay, has everybody done all five?
No, I have a good handle.
Okay, handle W is the time.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay.
Don't let go of the board. Okay, slowly lift it up if you want. Slowly lift it up. Tap the board. Hurry. No, it's nice. Okay, let go of the board. Slot the board slowly away. As you tap it.
There you go, David.
There you go. Take your hand, wave. Oh, you only got the wind doing it for you anyway, but. And you take that and you put it in the nest of mugwort.
It's too bad there's no mugwort. I guess we should have collected it.
I think there's some in a pouch.
Yeah, I don't want to take anybody else's mugwort.
I mean, it's a really simple process. I mean, all you do is you're going to be doing that. You're going to be sliding it in. And then you're going to blow on it. And that's how you're going to get, you know. And obviously you'll have like a thinner with you and stuff like that, your wood and stuff. Yeah, so you know. Because once you have that, everything else is pretty simple as long as you
Thank you.